Hi there! In this video, we're learning about user types, what they are, how to create them, and how they work on your marketplace. Online marketplaces need, at minimum, two types of users, supply and demand. In a peer-to-peer marketplace, a user can easily belong to both groups, that is, be a provider and a customer at the same time. But if you have a business-to-consumer or business-to-business marketplace, odds are that you'll need at least two different signup experiences, one for providers and one for customers. User types make this possible in your Sharetribe marketplace. With user types, you can create unique onboarding flows for supply and demand and ask new users different information, depending on their type. Let's learn how that happens. In console, navigate to user types. You'll find the settings in the build section under users. To create a new user type, click Add a new user type. If your marketplace already has default user types, you can either edit them or remove them and start from scratch. My example marketplace is for bike rentals, so I'll create a user type for bike owners who can be either individuals or businesses. The first thing to fill about your user type is a name and an ID. The name of this user type will be bike owner and the ID bike-owner. The user type name is visible on your marketplace when users sign up, if you have more than one user type. The user type ID is a unique identifier of this custom field that's not shown to users and will be stored in the user's data. You can choose the term that's most descriptive about your supply: seller, supplier, freelancer, service provider, etc. Use your own marketplace's terminology when choosing the user type name. Next up are the default user fields. Each user has a set of obligatory fields which you can see in the list grayed out. Every user needs to fill in an email, name, and password at signup, and their profiles will include an optional bio and profile picture. Further, if they take part in monetary transactions, they will be asked to add payout details or a payment method. There are two default fields you can choose to turn on or off: the display name and phone number, which we'll be taking a look at next. If you enable the display name, a user can choose to enter a nickname or alias when signing up. The display name will be presented in their profile instead of the user's name, formatted as first name and the first initial of their surname. I'll enable the display name for this user type. Bike rental businesses can enter a business name instead of just displaying one employee's name. When I enable the display name settings appear below. Here, I can decide if the field will be a part of the signup form and whether it's mandatory. I'll add the field to the signup form so that people can add a business name already when creating an account. But since not all of my renters are businesses, I will not make the field mandatory, meaning new users can also leave it empty. The phone number field lets you collect a confidential phone number from users. Only the user themselves and the marketplace operator can see it. I'll enable the phone number field and then determine the phone number settings. I'll add it to the signup form, but again, make it non-mandatory. I don't want to create any unnecessary friction during signup. People can add a phone number if they wish. That's our user type for bike owners, ready to go. I'll quickly create another user type for customers. This will be quite a bit simpler. Similarly to before, I'll enter a name and an ID for the user type, in this case, customer. For default fields, I'll turn off both the display name and phone number. I'm expecting my customers to be individual people like tourists or locals, and I want the least amount of steps to bring them on board. Under Users in Console, you can also find User Field Settings. These are custom information you can ask about your users during signup or in their user profiles. When you're creating a custom user field, you can limit it to specific user types, further differentiating the signup and user experiences between different user types. Enable the setting Limit this field to specific user types. Click Add a user type ID and copy and paste the user type ID you want to use there. Afterward, the user field is only available when someone chooses that user type at signup. Finally, let's check out how user types affect user experiences on your marketplace. Go to your test marketplace and click Sign Up to see the signup form. At the top of the form, your visitors choose what they're signing up as. Based on the choice, they'll need to fill in the different information you've chosen for each user type. You can also link directly to the signup flow of a specific user type. You can create these links by taking the signup URL and adding /user ID at the end. That's creating user types in Sharetribe. Let's do a quick recap. Marketplaces need at least two types of users, supply and demand. Depending on your platform, you may want to build different kinds of experiences for these user groups, one for providers and one for customers. User types make this possible in your Sharetribe marketplace. In Sharetribe, you determine a user type name and default fields and limit any further custom user fields to specific user types. Thanks for watching.